Guys, I'm super excited. I memorized Psalm 40, verse 5. I don't even need the picture to help me. But if you need it, we will do it one more time with the picture, then once without. I know you can do it. Are you ready? Psalm 40, verse 5. Many, O Lord my God, are thy wonderful works which thou hast done, and thy thoughts which are to us word, they cannot be reckoned up in order unto thee. If I would declare and speak of them, they are more than can be numbered. Psalm 40, verse 5. Now, last time without the picture. We got this. Psalm 40, verse 5. Many, O Lord my God, are thy wonderful works which thou hast done, and thy thoughts which are to us word, they cannot be reckoned up in order unto thee. If I would declare and speak of them, they are more than can be numbered. Psalm 40, verse 5. Great job! I'm excited to start a new verse next week, but I really enjoyed learning Psalm 40, verse 5, because it makes reference to God's glory. It starts by talking about his wonderful works. That makes me think of some of the miracles that Jesus has done. He calmed a storm, he healed the sick, he raised the dead, he fed a crowd of over 5,000 people with only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Now, why did Jesus do these miracles? Jesus performed miracles to glorify God, to show he is the Son of God, and to care for people. Because Jesus is God's Son, God's glory also belongs to Jesus. Now, what is God's glory? Well, I think back to Moses in the book of Exodus. When Moses was on the mountain before getting the Ten Commandments, he asked to see God's glory. God showed him a bright light. When Moses came down from the mountain, afterwards, his face was shining bright because he had seen God's glory. It was shining through him. But it's much more than that. God's glory is his character. It's who he is. He is loving, merciful, gracious, powerful, and almighty. When we worship God for who he is, we glorify him. In today's story, we talk about a time where Jesus showed his glory to 3 of his disciples. Let's not waste any time. Let's get started. You can follow along in your Bible by turning to Matthew 17. Jesus was walking up a mountain with his disciples, Peter, James, and John. Jesus wanted time alone to pray with them, but once there, the 3 disciples fell asleep. As Jesus prayed, his appearance suddenly changed. His face was shining like the sun, and his clothes were as white as the light. The disciples woke up and saw Moses and Elijah talking with Jesus. Peter said, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you want, I will set up 3 tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While Peter was still speaking, a bright cloud said, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear him." The disciples heard this, fell on their faces, and were afraid. Jesus came up and touched them. "Get up, don't be afraid." When they looked up, Moses and Elijah were gone. They only saw Jesus. As they were walking down the mountain again, Jesus told his disciples not to tell anyone of what they had seen until the Son of Man is risen from the dead. The disciples didn't tell anyone, but they wondered what Jesus meant. They asked him, "Why do the scribes say that Elijah must come before the Messiah comes?" Jesus explains that Elijah had already come. Well, someone who was a prophet, just like Elijah. But the people didn't know he was a prophet, and they mistreated him. Jesus told them, "In the same way, the Son of Man is going to suffer at their hands." The disciples then realized that Jesus was talking about John the Baptist. Remember him? His job was to prepare the way for Jesus, the Messiah. Jesus showed his glory to Peter, James, and John. Jesus said he would die, rise from the dead, and return to heaven one day. Jesus will come back to earth in his glory to make all things new. This story tells of the first time Jesus revealed his glory to humans, but it will not be the last time humans see Jesus in glory. When Jesus returns to earth wearing bright white clothing and shining brighter than the sun, he will destroy all evil and fix everything wrong in the world. Everyone who has faith in Jesus will receive new glorified bodies to live forever with God.